May I have your attention, please? Are your nostrils are quivering, tingling as well at the delicate, luscious ambrosial smell? Yes, they are, I can tell. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that aroma enriching the breeze is like nothing compared to its succulent sources. The gourmets among you will tell you, of course. Ladies and gentlemen, you can't imagine the rapture in store just inside of this door. There, your sample, Mrs. Lovett's meat pies, savory and sweet pies. As you'll see, you who eat pies, Mrs. Lovett's meat pies, conjure up the treat pies used to be.
Oh, little boy, how about some ale?
Ladies and gentlemen, coming, excuse me.
Elder.
Right, Mum.
Quick now.
God, that's good.
Nice to see you, dearie. How have you been keeping? Poor me bones is weary. Tell me, one for the gentleman here. The birdie's cheeping, helps to keep it cheery. Toby, throw the old woman out.
God, that's good.
What's your pleasure, dearie? To cut slices, call me eyes is bleary. Toby, none for the gentleman. I put up me prices. I'm a little leery. Business couldn't be better though.
God, that's good.
Knock on wood. Excuse me, dear. See to the customers. Yes, what love? Quick though, the trade is brisk.
It's 6 o'clock.
So it's 6 o'clock.
It's too true. I've had a quarter of 5 minutes.
And it's probably
o'clock.
Already down the block. It'll be.
I've been waiting all day.
Have a beaker of beer and
we'll
stop worrying.
We should be here by now.
Will you wait?
You'll come back when it comes.
Because my customers surely are getting unruly. What a pleasure, dearie. Oops, I beg your pardon. Just my hands are smeary. Toby, run for the gentleman. Don't you love a garden? Always makes me cheery. Must be one of them foreigners.
God, that's good. That is delicious.
It's
where
coming up the stairs.
I'll get rid of the salt, is it still pretty hot?
It's about to be open, or don't you care? But we have to prepare.
They'll never be sold if I let them get cold. Oh, incidentally, dearie, you know Mrs. Mooney. Sales have been so dreary. Toby, poor thing is penniless. What about that loony? Looking sort of beery. Oh, well, gotta come up and Zan'll be dropping
sand. God, that's good. So she should have you.
A chair fit for a king of wondrous neat and most particular. You tell me where is the receipt? Can half compete with this particular thing? I have a few minor adjustments to make. I'll take a moment.
I'll call.
I have another friend.
That a pie fit for a king, a wondrous, sweet, and most delectable thing. You see, ma'am, why there is no meat pie can compete with this delectable pie. The crust of velveteen waves, that glaze, those grits, and then the thick, succulent
rest.
What's
the it's time
that you rest.
Excuse me, dear, see to the customers. All set, love.
Quick, now.
Me heart's a flutter.
When I pound the floor.
When you pound the floor.
It's a signal to show
yes,
that I'm
told
ready
me,
to
I know
go when
be
I pound the floor.
When you pound the floor, will you trust me? Will
I just
you
want to be sure.
I'll be waiting below.
When I'm certain that
below.
You're in place, I'll pound three times. And then you, three times, if you, exactly.
Four hot points, four hot
points,
four points,
four points.
Stump slow cut,
that's a lot, and now we've sold it.
Come again tomorrow.
Hold it!
More hot pies!
Bless my eyes! Fresh supplies!
Come about it, that's a pie fit for a king. What's the rest of we done? Tell me, let's have a
yum. Have a
ma'am, why there was no need of pie.
Toby, throw the old woman out!
My turtle dove, my sweet Joanna.
Joanna.
Goodbye, Joanna. You're gone and yet you're mine. I'm fine, Joanna. I'm fine. The way ahead is clear, Joanna. Joanna, a star, a shooting star.
There,
less and less as every day goes by, Joanna.
What's all this hollering and shouting?
Oh, sir, there's been a monstrous perversion of justice. A young woman, as sane as you or I, has been locked up there.
Is that a fact? Now, what is this young person's name?
Joanna.
Joanna, that wouldn't by any chance be Judge Turpin's ward.
He's the one. He's the devil incarnate who has done this to us.
You watch your tongue. That girl's as mad as the seven seas. I brought her here myself, so hop it.
You have no right to order me about.
No right, eh? You just hop it, or I'm booking you for disturbing of the peace, assailing an
officer. Is there no justice in this city? Are the officers of the law just as vicious and corrupt as their masters? Joanna! Joanna! Joanna!
After him! Get him! Bash him on the head if need be. That's the sort of scallywag that gets his neighborhood into disrepute.
Who alas loves a lass, who alas has a lass in Canterbury. Tis a rodo dittle dowdy, tis a rodo dittle dowdy. Nothing like a nice sit down, is there, dear, after a hard day's work? Now let's see. We've got 4 threepence, 4 and 11 pence, that makes 7 pounds, 9 shillings and 4 pence for the week. Not bad. And that don't include what I had to pay out for my nice cheery picture. And this harmonium. And what a bargain it was, dear, it being only partly singed once the chapel burnt down. Now, Mr. T, are you listening to me?
Of course.
Then what did I say, eh?
There must be a way to the judge.
The bloody old judge, always hopping on the bloody old judge. We've got a nice respectable business, with money coming in regular, and since we're so careful to pick and choose, only strangers and like such won't be missed. Who's going to catch on? Ooh, Mr. Tom, I'm so happy. I could eat you up, I really could. You know what I'd like to do, Mr. Tom. What I dream, if the business stays as good, where I'd really like to go in a year or so. Don't you want to know?
Of course.
Do you really want to know?
Yes, yes, I do, I do.
I've always had this dream, ever since I was a skinny little slip of a thing. And my rich aunt Nettie would take me to the seaside. August bank all the day, the pier, making little castles in the sand. Oh, I can still feel my toes wiggling around in the briny. See, Mr. Todd, that's a life I covered by the sea. Mr. Todd, ooh, I know you'd love it. You and me, Mr. T, we could be alone in a house what we'd almost own down by the sea.
Anything you say.
Wouldn't let me smashing. The sea at our gate, we'll have kippered herring. What have swum to us straight from the Straits of Bering. Every night in the kip, when we're through our kippers, I'll be there slipping off your slippers by the sea with the fishy splashing. By the sea, wouldn't that be smashing? Down by the sea.
Anything you say.
for squawking. Hoo-hoo, I'll do me bacon. Then I'll go walking with you. Hoo-hoo, I'll warm me bones on the Esplanade. Have tea and scones with me gay young blade. Then I'll knit a sweater while you write a letter. Unless we got better to do.
Anything you say.
Think how snug it'll be underneath our flannel when it's just you and me and the English Channel. In our cozy retreat, kept all neat and tidy. We'll have chums over every Friday by the sea.
Anything you say.
Don't you love the weather? By the sea, we'll grow old together. Down by the seaside, blue, by the beautiful sea. Can see us now in our bathing dresses, you in a nice navy, and me, straps perhaps. It'll be so quiet that who'll come by it except a seagull. Hoo hoo, we shouldn't try it, though till it's legal for two. But a seaside wedding could be devised, me rumpled bedding. Legitimized. Me eyelids will flutter, I'll turn into butter the moment I mutter, I do. By the sea in our nest, we could share our kippers with the odd paying guest from the weekend trippers. Have a nice sunny suite for the guests to rest in. Now and then you can do the guesting by the sea. Lovely. Now, Mr. T, you do love me just a little bit, don't you?
Of course.
Then how about it? Of course, we'd have to make a little visit to St. Swithin's to legalize things, but that wouldn't be too painful, would it?
I'll make them pay for what they did to Lucy!
Now,
Mr.
Dear,
Todd!
It's high time you forgot all the morbid fancies. Your Lucy's gone, poor thing. It's your Nelly now. Here, have a nice bonbon. You know, it's 17 years this winter since my poor Albert passed on, and I don't see why I shouldn't be married in white, do you?
Mr. Todd! Mr. Todd! Mr. Todd! I have found her!
You have found Joanna?
That monster of a judge had her locked away in a madhouse!
Where?
Where no one can find her. Mr. Fogg's asylum. Oh, Mr. Todd, she's in there with other screeching, gibbering maniacs!
A madhouse! A madhouse! Joanna is as good as rescued!
She is?
Where do you suppose all the wigmakers of London go to obtain their human hair?
Who knows the morgue, dear? Wouldn't be surprised!
They get their hair from the lunatics at Bedlam.
Then you think?
Fogg's asylum, why not? For the right amount, they'll sell you the hair off of any madman's head.
And the scalp to go with it, too, if requested. Excuse me, gentlemen, I'm out.
We'll write a letter to this Mr. Fogg offering the highest price for hair, the exact shade of Joanna's, which I trust you know.
Yellow.
Not exact enough. I must make you into a credible wig maker, and quickly.
Sweeney waited too long before. Oh, but never again he's four.
Fortune arrived, Sweeney is saying. Sweeney was ready and Sweeney sprang.
Sweeney's problems went up in smoke. Or is over with a single stroke.
Sweeney was sharp, Sweeney was burning. Sweeney began the engine turning.
Sweeney was sharp, Sweeney was burning. Sweeney began the engine turning. Sweeney, 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 Sweeney.
Here's money, and here's the pistol for kill if you must kill.
Kill a dozen jailers if it sets her free.
Then off with you off. But actually, listen to me once again. Once you have rescued her, bring her back here. And I'll guard her while you hide the chains to blame.
We'll be with you before the evening's out. Mr. Todd, thank you, friend.
To write you this urgent note to warn.
this to Judge Turpin. It's urgent.
Sewed out sign up, ma'am.
That's me, boy. Look, dear, a lovely muffler. And guess who it's for?
Cool, ma'am. For me.
Wouldn't you like to know?
Oh, you're so good to me, ma'am. Sometimes, when I think what it was like with Signor Pirelli, it seems like the good Lord has sent you for me.
Oh, but it's just me warm heart, dear, room enough air for all God's creatures.
You know, there isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. If there was a monster, or an ogre, or anything bad like that was after you, I'd rip him apart with my bare fists, I would.
Oh, what a sweet child it is.
Or even if it was just a man.
A man, dear?
A man. One might be luring you all unbeknownst into his evil deeds, like.
What is this? What are you talking about?
Nothing's gonna harm you, not while I'm around.
Of course not, dear, and why should it?
Nothing's gonna harm you, no sir, not while I'm around.
What do you mean, a man?
Demons are prowling everywhere nowadays.
So they are, dear.
I'll send them howling, I don't care, I've got ways.
Of course you do, what a sweet, affectionate child it is.
No one's gonna hurt you, no one's gonna dare.
I know what Toby deserves.
Others will desert you, not to worry, whistle, I'll be there.
Yeah, have a nice one.
Demons will charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing's going to harm you, not while I'm around.
What is this foolishness? What are you talking about?
Little things, what I've been thinking and wondering about. You see, it's Mr. Todd. Oh, I know you fancy him, but men ain't like women. They what can't be trusted as. I've lived and learned. Not to worry, not to worry. I may not be smart, but I ain't dumb. I can do it, put me to it, show me something I can overcome. Not to worry, being close and being clever ain't like being true. I don't need to, I won't never hide a thing from you like some.
Now, dear, haven't we had enough foolish chatter for once? Let's just sit here.